Let's now shift a little bit. I wanted to ask you, Simon, what is your read on consumers right now? I mean, what are your data telling you about the state of play? And if you ever compare notes with heads from other countries, how do Philippine consumers stack up against their peers, maybe in Vietnam or in Singapore, in Hong Kong, or even China?
So we always sit in country manager meetings where we compare our numbers, and the Philippines is actually doing quite well. In fact, in terms of spend recovery, there's a lot of spend happening now in travel. So middle of last year, we opened up in terms of travel. And, you know, Hong Kong used to be the second largest travel corridor for the Philippines. And they really didn't open up till the end of last year. So we're seeing a second kick in terms of travel recovery. Now, in terms of consumer spending, I noted that in your news earlier, you were highlighting that inflation might still be a key fear. But what we're seeing is consumers continue to spend quite well, not just on essentials, but also on non-essential travel or spending. So you see a lot of people going out in terms of going to the restaurants, and they want to experience these things.
Simon, you're not seeing anything remotely recessionary?
No, not at the
moment. Perhaps discretionary trade-offs as people try to make ends meet, despite worries about the next 6 to 12 months with the economy slowing down. You know, people still want to make things work, so they buy this and not that. They buy a little of this, more of that.
It's a good question, Mimi. And what we're seeing is people, in terms of spending, especially when they're going out to eat, they're spending less on high-ticket restaurants, but continue to go to spend out in probably lower to medium priced restaurants.
That's an interesting.
And one more thing, in terms of grocery spending, you used to see large ticket grocery spending online, but now as people return to face-to-face grocery spending, you're seeing them go to the grocery more often, but smaller ticket sizes.
Smaller baskets, but more frequent. You mentioned inflation. You know, we are seeing it moderate a bit, 3 months easing already. I understand that moderate inflation, it's quite helpful to your business. Where does it stand now? Is that good or bad? Because, you know, I was listening to some analysts and they were saying medium, short-term, moderate inflation is good because it raises the overall volume in spending.
Correct. Well, even during the high inflationary environment, we continue to see very strong spending. So the fact that we're seeing inflation taper off, like you mentioned, the past 3 months, it's down to 6.6%. I think you can continue to be seeing good news in terms of consumer spending for the next few months.
All right. You know, we've gotten intimately familiar with just how painful inflation can be, but it is easing, as I mentioned. How do you see, what's your forecast for inflation? We're at 6.6 now. How quickly will it drop, you think? And do you think this drop is going to drive your business further or drag borrowings?
You know, that's not my line of expertise, but what we can talk about is how inflation is currently affecting consumer spending. And for now, we continue to see that consumer spending is up. What we're seeing in terms of travel spending, it's a lot of business travel and a lot of the affluent and mass affluent segment continuing to travel. So what we don't see a lot of is the budget traveling.
All right, the budget traveling, not so much. Not yet. In the Philippines in particular, Simon, we're also watching delinquency, rising credit card debt. I mean, what are you seeing on those fronts? Are we finding our way back to pre-crisis levels?
Absolutely. In fact, if you talk to some of the banks, the delinquency levels are already better than pre-pandemic.
Okay. All right. All right. And you mentioned this earlier, travel, the recovery in travel and overseas spending. I heard somewhere it's the single most important thing for companies like MasterCard. What else can you share with us on overseas spending?
So on overseas spending, you used to see a lot of people buying luxury goods. You don't see a lot of that anymore. What you see people spending more when they travel, it's really on experiences. Like they want to watch a show, or go to Disneyland or something like that.
It's more experiences rather than goods and stuff. Right. Final question, Simon. Everybody's going digital. How helpful is mobile banking and e-wallets to your business? Would you call them a boon or a bane?
Extremely helpful. In fact, MasterCard really believes in technology being a power for good. And technology has to be scalable. And when it's scalable, it can be very inclusive. So absolutely, it's a good thing.
And this digital world, you know, contactless digital world, it won't hurt, you know, the plastic culture, because we still consider MasterCard belonging to the plastic culture. You hold the plastic card.
You know, a lot of people think about MasterCard as a credit and debit card company. Mm-hmm. We're much more than that. We're a technology company in the payment space. So even if plastics disappear, we'll continue to, you know, be in the lives of consumers through payments.
And final question, we've got 110 million Filipinos in our population. What's your coverage today?
Out of those 110, we have 20 plus million debit card holders, about 6 million credit card holders.
Are you happy with those numbers? What's the target?
Well, our enemy is cash. So we want full coverage of the 110.
All right, and how soon?
Hopefully in the next 5-10 years, we're able to achieve that target.
All right, on that note, Simon, pleasure to speak with you. Thank you so much for sharing the insights on the consumers this morning.
Thank you for having me, Mimi.
All right.